will be starting new topic in your theoretical distribution. Okay, in theoretical distribution, previous classes in we have been seeing two type of distribution. Okay, one is Bernal distribution, first one. Second one we have seen binal distribution. One is Bayes' problem, unbiased problem, and fitting a binomial distribution. So today's class will be seeing Poisson distribution. So what is Poisson distribution? Before going to see what is Poisson distribution, we will see how it has been converted to Poisson distribution. So parameter of binomial distribution, we know that is NP. What is this parameter of binomial distribution? It is known as NP, where Bernal distribution is tend to Poisson distribution. Okay, where Bernal distribution is tend to Poisson distribution means when N is larger. If N is larger and P is smaller. If N is larger and P is small, then my Bernal distribution will be converted as my Poisson distribution. Here the mean of binomial distribution is tend to Poisson distribution with limiting, what it is? With limiting form of binomial distribution. Of binomial distribution. So my Poisson distribution mean is the limited form of my binomial distribution. Okay. And here my Poisson distribution is NP denoted with lambda. How it has been denoted? With lambda. My NP in Poisson distribution is lambda here, okay? Now, I will take an example to show you how my binomial distribution problem only is being changed to my Poisson distribution, okay? See an example in a college, 60% students are boys. In a random sample of 5 students, find probability of 2 are boys. What it is? Find probability 2 are boys. This is a binomial distribution problem. How we are telling it is a binomial distribution problem means, see here, N is 5. So what here in a college, 60% boy students are boys, okay? In a random sample 5 or in a random sample of 5, find probability of 2, that is 2 are boys. My N is 5 and P is 2. What is my N is 5 and P is 2, where X is 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Where my X is 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Here my N and P are small. My N and P are small. N is 5, P is small. This one. 2. The same question, okay? In a college, 60% students are boys. In a random sample of 500 students, find three are two. That is two are boys. See here the same question. Same question. In a college 60% are boy. In a college 60% are boy. In a random sample of 5. In a random sample of 500. Find probability 2 odd boys. Find probability 2 odd boys. Here, this question is called as Poisson distribution. Y means N is 500 and P is 2. Where X is 0, 1, 2, up to 500. Here, my N is large, that is 500. My P is small, that is 2. When my N is large and P is small, this is being changed to my Poisson distribution. What it has been changed to my Poisson distribution. See here, parameter of binomial distribution is N and P. Binomial distribution can be 10 to Poisson distribution when my N is large and P is small. Mean of my Bernoulli distribution is 10 to my Poisson distribution with limiting, and my Poisson distribution NP is denoted by lambda. It is not lambda, it is lambda. Lambda. And I have given example of a question where my binary distribution, okay, my binary distribution is 10 to my Poisson distribution. See, in a college, 60% boys are students are boys. In random sample, 5 students, 2 should be boys. So N is 5, P is 2, where my X are between 0 and 5. Here N and P are small. Same question, if there are 500 students and probability is 2. Here my N is 500, P is 2, where my X are 0 to 500. Here my X, when my N is bigger than my P. Same question, that is Bernoulli distribution question is being changed to Poisson distribution when my N changes. When my N changes here. A definition of Poisson distribution. See here. If X is a discrete random variable with probability mass function, that is P of X is equals to E minus lambda into lambda to the power X divided by X factorial. What it is? If it is a discrete random variable, then my P of X will be E minus lambda E to the power minus lambda into lambda to the power X divided by X factorial. Where my X are 0, 1, 2, 3, infinite. Because in my Poisson distribution, my N will be large. Where my lambda is always positive. Greater means what it is? Positive. Then X is a Poisson variant and the distribution of X is called as Poisson distribution. What it is? The X, if this lambda is more, then the X is a Poisson variant and the distribution is called as Poisson distribution. Now, Poisson distribution table, where X, P of X, if my X is 0, okay, that is P of X is 0. when it is 0. Same thing when it is 1, I'll get e minus lambda, e to the power minus lambda into lambda to the power 1 divided by 1. When it is 1, I will get e minus lambda e to the power minus lambda, then lambda. Then if my x is 2, I will get here 2 and 2 into 1. 2 factorial is 2 into 1. Here I will get e to the power minus lambda into lambda square divided by 2. Then if it is 3 factorial. So I will get here e to the power minus lambda into lambda 3 power 3 divided by 3 into 2 is 6. So 6 factorial, okay. This will be continuing up to the end. This is called as quotient distribution. This table is called as, what this table is called? This table is called as quotient distribution with parameter lambda. With parameter lambda. So here for Bernal distribution also I have given you table. For binary distribution also I have given you table, and this is for quotient distribution table. So you need to write this table, is there in your textbook. So you need to write this table. Okay, I will just send you the photo. Now here the example for your quotient distribution are number of deaths occurring in a city in a day. Okay, city is a large. What is city? Your city is considering N, it is a large. Death is probability, okay? Possibility of death, that is your P. Like that. Now, next, moving on to the future, one by one. First future is, quotient distribution has only one parameter, that is their yield. So, how many parameters are there in quotient distribution? One parameter, and that is yield. For a quotient distribution, the probability mass function of x is p of x is equals to e to the power minus lambda into lambda to the power x divided by x factorial. The second one is where we have probability mass function, that is p to the power x is equals to e to the power x minus lambda into lambda to the power x divided by x factorial. The third point, x are 0, 1, 2 up to infinity is a range of quotient distribution where my x are until infinity because it is a large number. Then for a quotient distribution, mean is equal to lambda and variance is also equal to lambda. My mean and variance value of any number with decimal point. That is 1.5 or 5.8 or 6.7. Okay? It is not an integral, means it is not a whole number. Integral means it is not a whole number. That positions are unimodal. Unimodal means one value. Okay? And the integral part of lambda is the unimodal value. Here, in the case if it is not the integers, that time we will be considering only the integral value, that is 1, 5, 6. This integers value we will ignore. What we will be doing? We will ignore, and that is called as unimodal, that is 1. Is called as unimodal. Next, if lambda is the integral for Poisson distribution are bimodal. Bi is two value, and the two models are at. So, for example, here. If my integrals are 2, 8, 7, 9. So these are the whole integrals. For if it is that case, I will be getting two values, that is delta minus 1. Sorry, lambda minus 1. Where my lambda is 2 here, 2 minus 1 is 1 and 2. If it is 8 minus 1. Then 7 and 8. Then 7 minus 1, 6 and 7. That is 2 model, bimodal. When lambda is an integral, is not, it is an integral. Poisson distribution is bimodal and 2 models are lambda minus 1 and lambda 1. So I will be getting lambda minus 1 is 1 and lambda is 2. Lambda minus 1 is 7 and 8. Like this I will be getting. Next, Poisson distribution is positively skewed, then beta 1 is greater than 0. If it is, my Poisson distribution is positively skewed, that time my beta 1 is greater than 0. Then Poisson distribution is Lactuc-Krupp, then beta 2 is greater than 3. If my Poisson distribution is Lactuc-Krupp, then my beta 2 is greater than 3. When lambda is larger, Poisson distribution can be considered to the normal distribution. When my lambda is greater or larger, then it is called as normal distribution. So this is the future of my Poisson distribution. So once again I will explain you. See here. Definition of Poisson distribution. If my x is a discrete random variable with probability mass function, then I will get p of x is equals to e to the power minus lambda into lambda to the power x divided by x factorial, where my x are 0, 1, 2, 3 up to infinite. In my Poisson distribution, my lambda will be always positive value, that is greater value. power 2 divided by 2 factorial. Then if it is 3, e to the power minus lambda, lambda to the power 3 divided by 6. This table is called as Poisson distribution of parameter of lambda. Then future, my parameter is only one variable with lambda, and my second one is probability of mass function of x is equals to p of x, that is e to the power minus lambda into lambda to the power x divided by x factorial, where third one is x is equals to 1, 2, 3 up to infinity. Then that is the range. Then my Poisson distribution, mean is equals to lambda, variance is equals to lambda, and standard deviation is lambda root. Your mean and variance are equal. What is here? My mean, my Poisson distribution, mean and variance are equal. When lambda is not an integral, integral means it is not a whole number with decimal points, then my Poisson distribution is called as unimodal. Unimodal means one value. Already there are two values. Okay, so 2.582 values. So I am going to convert into one value, that is called as unimodal. And the integral part of lambda is unimodal value. Next, if my lambda is integral, then Poisson distribution is bimodal. So if it is 2, I am converting to unimodal. If it is 1, I am converting to 2. Okay, that is a different, simple difference. Then it is bimodal, that is lambda minus 1 and lambda. Next, Poisson distribution is positively skewed if, that is, my beta 1 is greater than 0. What it is? If my Poisson distribution is positively skewed, then beta 1 is greater than 0. If Poisson distribution is lambda-crypt, then beta 2 is greater than 3. Then when lambda is larger, my Poisson distribution can be considered to be normal distribution. It has been considered as normal distribution. So this is the theoretical part of my Poisson distribution. Next class will be solving problems on Poisson distribution, how they are being solved for my Bernal distribution. Okay, for my Bernal and binomial distribution we are being solved, right? Same thing will be doing for my Poisson distribution.